Hello friends, Namaste. Today we are going to solve another problem that is on a projection of solids. So the problem is been given over here. So what is been given? It is a pentagonal prism of 25mm sides of base and 60mm axis length rest on HP on one of its edges of the base. Draw the projection of the prism when the axis is inclined to HP at how much? 40 degrees and VP at 30 degrees. See the data is been written over here. So the first data that is required for us to write the step number one, it is the type of solid. Here it is a pentagonal prism of 25mm sides of base and 60mm axis length is 60mm axis resting on one of its edges of the base. So that is the first data that is required and that has been written over here. So here I have written a pentagon in such a way that one of its edge is coming to the right side. Which is the edge to the right side? C1 and D1 is the edge, base edge to the right side. Okay, I have written the pentagon and you make sure the pentagon must be dark. So how many corners are there over here? So there are totally 10 corners are there. So A, B, C, D, E, D and E represents what? Top corners, whereas A1, B1, C1, D1, E1 represents the bottom face corner. So when you're looking from the top, only the top face is visible. Hence A1, B1, C1, D1 that represent the bottom face. So that has been placed inside the parenthesis. Next, we have to draw the front view. Next, for that, the observer will be looking from this side. So for the observer, which are the corners are visible? A1 is visible, B1 is visible, C1 is visible. So these are the six corners are visible and corresponding edges is visible. The same thing has been represented over here. The visible lines are made dark. Okay, so here A1 dash A dash, that is a representation how we are going to represent the front view. So this is a front view and this one is a top view. And B1 dash B dash is visible, C1 dash and C dash is visible. And the invisible edges are D1 dash and D dash, E1 dash and E dash. So that has been represented inside the parenthesis, as well as axis is also not visible. Okay, have you got this? So next step, the step number two is, what is the inclination with respect to the HP? So which one is inclined? The axis is inclined at an angle of how much? 40 degree to HP. And it is resting on one of its base edge. Therefore, so C1 dash and D1 dash is the resting edge. And it is inclined at an angle of how much? 40 degree. So this has been represented over here. This drawing and this drawing both must be similar. Only the axis here is inclined at an angle of how much? 40 degree. After doing that one, I have drawn the projections and also located all the corners. So what is this? This is a front view. From here I have to draw the top view. Okay, so I am going to tell you step by step method once again how to draw the visible and invisible edges over here. And visible edges has been represented with a continuous line, whereas invisible lines are represented with a dashed like discontinuous lines. Okay, so this is how we are going to represent the visible and invisible lines, invisible edges. Okay, so now the first step is to identify the resting edge or corner. So here, which is a resting edge? C1 and D1 is the resting edge. What we have to do? We have to represent them inside the parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis. What is the meaning of that? C1 and D1 is invisible. Now, so the lines which are going from these two corners will be invisible. So we will be having a line from C1 to D1. And also we have line from D1 to E1, correct? Next, we have line from B1 to C1, Okay, so this is step number one, and once again we have vertical edges, right? So that is C1 to C, we have a vertical edges, and also we have a vertical edges from D1 to D. I got this one. So this is a step number one, identify the resting edge or corner and enclose them in parentheses. The lines which are going from these corners will be invisible. The step number two is identify the face nearer to the observer. So here, which face is near to the observer? This is a front face and this one is a bottom face. So this is a top face and it's a bottom face. So to the observer, which face is near to the observer? Top face is nearer to the observer, so therefore the top face must be dark. So I'm going to draw the top face dark. So the top face is represented as ABCD. This is the representation of what? Top face. So what is the next step? Step number three, the outermost boundary must be dark. So the outermost boundary, so it starts from here, E2, E1, E1 to A, A1, A1 to B1, B1 to B. Now, what is the next step? Though the three steps are over, now identify the remaining vertical edges. So how many edges does the pentagonal prism is having? Pentagonal prism is having how many? 5 vertical edges. Out of those 5 vertical edges, B1, B is already been joined, C1, C is joined, D1, D is joined, E1, E is joined. The only one left out vertical edge is A1 to A. So that means identify the remaining vertical edges, and the remaining vertical edges must be dark. In this case, only one vertical edge is remaining, so that is A1 to A. So this must be dark. Okay, so and also you have to represent the axis line. See here, A1A, O1O is overlapping. From here to here, it is a axis line. Have you got this one? So this is a step number two. So next step number three is axis is inclined at 30 degree to VP. So here there is no word called as appears. If there is no word called as appears, then we have to check for beta. So which one is inclined to VP? Axis is inclined to VP at an angle of how much? 30 degree. Okay. So therefore we have to check for beta. How to check for beta? What is the true length of the axis? It is 60. Now, after drawing the top view, what is the apparent length of the axis you have to make down? You have to check the apparent length of the axis. So, how much is this? It is 45 mm. Okay. So now how to check whether it comes under beta angle or not? What is the true length? It is 60. What is the apparent length? Apparent length of an axis? It is 45. Is true length is equal to apparent length? No. Here true length is not equal to apparent length. And also in the problem, they are not given the word called as appears. Hence, this will come under beta angle. This is a problem related to beta angle. So here what they are given? Axis is inclined at an angle of 30 degree. So I have drawn a line which is inclined at an angle of 30 degree. And also I marked the O. Now measure the apparent length of the axis. Measure the apparent length of the axis from here to here. So what is this? This is apparent length. Sorry. So first you have to measure what? True length of the axis that I am going to get from here. So O2 O1 dash. I'm going to take this one as what? O1 dash. So O1 dash is a apparent length, is a true length of axis. So next, what I am going to do, I am going to draw a horizontal line. Now, with the help of compass, measure the apparent length of the axis that you are going to get from the top view. So here O2, I am going to cut on this locus of O1. This is the locus of O1 dash. So what is this? So this is a O1. So now, now I am going to draw the line. So this is the beta. You have to measure the beta. Now I have to shift this top view on this beta angle line. So for that, I am going to enclose this object in a box. I'm going to name this one as 1, 2, 3 and 4. So now I'm going to first construct this box. Okay. I need another reference lines, that is, this one is called as 5, and here I'm going to take this one as 6 as well as 7. So for it will be very easy for me to identify all remaining corners. Okay, so first I'm going to identify 5. So what is the dimension from O to 5? Take the distance, take the measurement. O to 5, put it on this beta angle line. So this is 5, and also measure the distance from O1 to A1, the arc. I have to just extend this line. Okay, so this one is here is 5, and this one is A1. From both the things, I am going to draw a perpendicular lines. So it must be thin line, but I am using a dark pencil so that it will be easy for you to identify. Okay. So now take the distance from 5 to 3. Cut the arc, so it will be same from A1 to 4, cut the arc. Now take the measurement from A1 to 1, and also 5 to 2, it will be same. So what is this? This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Join this. Okay. So I got 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 5. So now I have to measure 7 and 6. For that, I am going to take the compass, take the measurement from 1 to 7. It is between 1 to 2, cut the arc, and this is also 4 to 6. Okay, so this one is 7 and this one is 6. Okay, got this one. So now I have to represent remaining corners. So with the help of compass, take the measurement from 1 to B. So here it will be 1 to B, this is B. And this one is E1. This one is B1. And this one is E1. Okay. In the same way, measure the distance from 2 to B. It is between 1 and 2. 2 to B. And also it will be same from 3 to E. So what is this? So this one is B and this one is E. So now I need to locate C1 and D1 so that I can get it from here. That is 7 to D, and it will be same from 6 to C1. Okay, so and also just draw the line over here. So here you can identify this one is D1 and this one is C1. In the same way, have to locate the D and also C. This is D and C. So it's D and this one is C. So is everything is over? No, we left it to another thing, that is the A1 to A. So what is this? This is a A. So we got all the things. So next is we have to redraw the same thing. Okay, so after drawing this top view and placing it over on this beta angle line, the next step is to draw the projection to draw the final front view. I have drawn the projections and located all the corners as you can see here. So now we have to write the visible and invisible edges over here. I will explain you step by step method. Please pay attention. So to write the final front view, the observer will be looking from this side. So to the observer, so you need to identify the step number one is to identify the face nearer to the observer. So this is a bottom face and this one is a top face. So here which face is nearer to the observer? The bottom face is nearer to the observer. Therefore, the face nearer to the observer must be dark. I will repeat once again, the step number one is to identify the face nearer to the observer. The face nearer to the observer must be dark. So here the bottom face is nearer, hence the bottom face must be dark. So the bottom face is represented as A1 B1, C1 D1, like that. So it will be represented A1 B1 C1 D1 represents what? Bottom face. So therefore, I am making bottom face dark. So this is a step number one. So what is the step number two? The step number two is the outermost boundary must be dark. Okay. So outermost, I am going to take it from C1. So C1 to C. So this is step number two. Outermost boundary must be dark. Then C1 to C dash to B dash, then B dash to A dash. Okay, see here is a situation. So here only my students are getting confused. Please pay attention over here. See, so which is the next outermost? See, my students will take it as E dash. Why it is not E dash means, if I join A dash to E dash the dark line, so then next outermost will be which one? A1 dash. Please make sure that my friends, there is no vertical edge from A1 dash to E dash. Hence, so here the outermost will be A dash to A1 dash, not A dash to E dash. Have you got this one? So this is where you are making the mistake. A dash to A1 dash is the outermost. Got this one? Any doubts? So this is the outermost. What is the step number 3? Now, after drawing the boundary in the bottom face. Why bottom face? Since the bottom face is nearer to the observer, in this bottom face, identify the top corner after the boundary. Which is the top corner we have after the boundary? We have is the B1 dash. Okay, so the vertical edge which is going from B1 dash to B dash, it will be dark. Is there is any other top edges are there? No other top edges are there. So that is what the step number 3. Identify the top corners in the bottom face after the boundary. So this is the top corner after the boundary. Now step number 3 is identify the corners which is not been touched. Sorry, step number 4. Identify the corners which is not yet been touched. See, D1, D dash is not touched and also E dash is not been touched. So therefore, I am going to place them in the parenthesis. Now, any line which are going from these two corners will be what? Invisible. Super. So there is a D dash to E dash. And also D dash to C dash, next E dash to A dash. Okay, so next one more vertical edge is there, that is the line which is going from E1 dash to E dash. Okay, so there is another one is there, that is D dash to D1 dash. So these are the edges which are going from where? E dash and D dash. Have you got this one? So next, at last we have to represent the axis, that is very much important, otherwise you're going to lose the marks. Okay, so for make you to understand, I have drawn this in a pen. Please draw it with the help of a pencil. Okay, please, this is the final front view. Okay, this is a final top view. Got this? Thank you. Namaste.